Sure. I get the message. Goodbye.
You were like a total stranger. It was scary.
I'm sorry, Oliver. It's just a policy I have to stick to. I can't take a call in the middle of one of those meetings that makes me sound like a lovesick teenager.
I just don't know how you can play roles like that, Marcie. How you can put one hat on, take one hat off so arbitrarily.
Well, it's not all that difficult once you get used to it.
I don't think I want to get used to it.
No one's asking you to.
What do you mean by that?
I just mean that when you met me, I wasn't in the kitchen cooking casserole. I work, Oliver. I like it. I mean, this is it. Accept it. I don't try to change you.
Well, what are you then, a business magnate or a woman?
Well, Oliver, what are you, a man or a lawyer? What kind of question is that?
I would just like to know if I am to be your boyfriend on the weekends and then during the week I'm just another one of those telephone calls that's put on hold.
Oliver, I never put you on hold. My God, I can't believe it. Do you always exaggerate like this? I mean, what if you're in the middle of a meeting with the senior partners and someone named, for God's sake, Marcie calls? I mean, what do you do?
Well, that's easy. First I would resign and then I would call you back from the unemployment office.
I'm sorry, Oliver. It's just that I'm trying to be more than a decoration at a board meeting, and it ends up taking a lot out of me. I get really tired of doing it all alone.
Well, I'm exhausted, too. This case has taken 10 times more work than I expected.
What a pair. Listen, I'm going to Hong Kong on Tuesday. I have to check out some factories there and handle a photo session. You want to come with me and we'll make a working vacation out of it?
Hong Kong? Well, isn't that halfway around the world?
Exactly.